Welcome to Unity Inspired Living. Our community began in 1989 as a small worldwide Unity book study group, and we've continued the momentum as an ever-evolving spiritual community. Each Sunday, you will find dynamic thought leaders delivering inspiring messages and talented musicians sharing sound healing through their melody. Here, we embrace ancient spiritual traditions, universal truths, and emerging wisdom. Let's check out this Sunday message. We're so grateful you've joined us.
I'm so grateful to be here together. I extend my great love and blessing over you today. My name is Amy Van Ling, and I am gratefully, joyfully, thankfully your spiritual director here of this divine community full of bright, radiant souls. We are Unity Inspired Living, and I consider this a divine appointment each week to be with you, sharing a divine experience. And I invite you to take that deep, conscious, inward breath of the spirit as you enter into our space here and allow yourself to move into your center of being, the truth of who and what you are, and know that your presence, your essence, you are a gift to this world. And we thank you for being here, for shining your light and bringing your beautiful essence to this space. We're grateful you said a sacred yes to be here in this moment, communing with this community. Know that we are so grateful. We are so grateful to be together. Our theme for the month of October has been, and this is the last Sunday of October, so we are wrapping it up today. It has been traversing timeless truth. And we've been invited this month to traverse this ancient timeless wisdom and truth that lives within us. You know, this inner knowing, which is guided by divine intelligence, speaks to us in every moment, beyond all circumstances, reminding us of our innate wholeness, our innate potential, the possibilities. And when we embrace that spiritual wisdom, that timeless truth, we align ourselves with God, with a powerful force that consistently, never in absence, guides, heals, inspires our lives. So I am grateful that we have our amazing Michael J. Allen here today. I'm enthusiastic, thrilled to introduce to you this beautiful being. And if you know him already, you're already clapping saying, yay, I'm so glad to have him back. He's an exquisite spirit being, divine, powerful essence in the world. And he is guiding us today as we traverse timeless truth with the message, the mysterious, powerful, present moment. Be with that in this moment. Thank you, Michael J., for your essence, for your heart, for your soul, for saying sacred yes to us this morning. There will be a workshop today from 11:30 to 12:30, and that is on a separate Zoom link. So you will log out of Facebook and go into the Zoom room, and you can find that link on our homepage, unityinspiredliving.org. And I'm also going to drop it right here in the feed on the Facebook live stream chat as we conclude. So you can pop into that Zoom room any which way you find yourself. And the workshop today is Being God, Goddess. And I am ready for this. And I know Michael J. has something special planned for us. And look at his hearts. I love that. We love you. We're so thankful for you. Thank you for being with us this morning from Flint, Michigan, all the way from Michigan. Thank you. Thank you, beloved. Mwah. We love you. We bless you. We love and appreciate you. And we also have on the screen the sensational, spectacular musician, Brittany Gilmore. She is back with us, sharing her heart and harmony. We are so tremendously grateful every single time you say sacred yes to us for your presence. You bring us magical melody. It is always like this harmonious, deep healing, your voice, your music, your soul, soulful singing. Thank you. We are so deeply grateful for you. And Brittany zooms in with us from LA, City of Angels. We are so blessed by you. Thank you, Brittany, for saying yes to us. We have also on our screen, last but not least, the gloriously brilliant bright light we call Jan Knight. She is a divine being here at our spiritual center, and she's here to share our selected inspirational reading today and community reminders and a prayer of plentitude. And we're so thankful for your sacred yes and your willingness to always show up for our community. We are blessed, truly blessed by you, the gift of you. Thank you, precious souls on the screen, and thank you, precious souls. I was going to say zooming in, but you are Facebook live streaming in to our Sunday experience here. And it takes all of us to co-create this magnificent, magical, deeply healing space. And thank you all for committing your time, your energy, your soul to coming together to activate the high vibration of love in this community. And then we share that out into the world. And that is what lights our fire around here. So thank you, everybody. Let me check in to see who is here. Hi, Nancy. Nancy says, good morning. I'm grateful to be here too. Florence says, good morning. Yay. Mimi's here. Good morning. My mom is here. Cecilia is here. Good morning, everyone. Jennifer says, Sunday morning blessings, everyone. Michael, welcome, Michael and Brittany. Thank you, Amy and Jan, for your continued loving dedication to support our precious community's highest good. Thank you, precious being. Hi, I see Steve is here. Hi, Steve. And Dusty's here. Welcome in, beloveds. So grateful to see all of you here this morning. It is really a divine appointment, and I am truly blessed. So let's create a reverent space here as we activate our mission statement. Just, planting that seed, reminding us, what are we doing? And we are fostering love and wisdom, inspiring transformation, offering compassionate outreach, and embracing unity. And I am so grateful to be on this journey together with all of you. I'm going to hand the screen over now to Brittany. She has our community song to open us up with. Remember, sing along, open that throat chakra and the heart space, and get all the energy flowing. Thank you, Brittany. We love and appreciate you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm so grateful to be here and be part of this community. So please do sing along with me. If you don't know the song, I think you will, but if you don't, our chorus is just, I am light. Our words are so powerful. So as we speak this into existence, it's very real. The vibrations are real. The intentions are real. So let's sing this together. Skin on the outside. I am not my age. I am Thank you so much.
Thank you, precious Brittany. That is definitely a favorite. Love
Me
that one.
too.
And everybody just be with that for a second. Like, I am light. Like, feel that light in you and shine it bright. Thank you for bringing that to us this morning. I feel like I haven't heard that one in a while. So
Oh,
thank you.
good.
Yeah.
It's a great one.
Okay, I'm going to hand the screen over to Jan. She has our community announcements and inspirational reading for us this morning. Thank you so much, Jan.
Oh, thank you, Amy. And thanks, Brittany. My favorite. Talk about a timeless truth. I am light. Yes, here we are. Okay, everybody, a few announcements. I want to start with reminding you that Michael J is having a workshop after the service. Starts at 11:30. He's titled it Being God, Goddess. So not only am I light, I am God. Right, Michael? All right. So be sure to come if you can, and you don't want to miss it because we have this great just we have great discussions. So be there if you can, and we always appreciate love offerings. Also note that we have a special fund now that we set up in October, I think the beginning of October, for the hurricane relief effort. And if you'd like to contribute, you can make a donation by Zelle or PayPal or check. Or and be sure to indicate on the memo that it's for the hurricane relief. Our donations go directly to families in need, and we'll be sending that money on probably by the end of this month. And we are sending out a huge heartfelt thank you to all of you who are continuing to support the Mitchell Van Ling Family Memorial Fund each month. And please remember to do that before the end of the month. So that it can be counted for this monthly donation. Coming up next Sunday is the big announcement. In person, we are putting together a spiritual books and jewelry fundraiser. And I wish everybody online could be there because it's going to be magnificent. And so we're asking you to look in your closets, clean out your bookshelves, and find spiritual books and jewelry that you're ready to put into circulation and know that you are ready to find new treasures when you come next Sunday or on the 16th of November to Pat's house. So our jewelry and spiritual book sale will be in person on the first Sunday, November 3rd, at the Antioch Community Center in the West Island Room. Come early before the service to take a look at and at look at all the choices that you have, and stay late to drop off your donations and to find the treasures. We're going to be showcasing specifically those of you who remember Gloria Harold. She made her transition last year, and her daughter Julie is donating many of her beautiful gemstone jewelry designs that she made. And as a contribution to our Unity Inspired Center. So also you may bring your items. This is a new addition. You could bring your items to my house to put them in circulation, and you could bring them on Friday, November 1st from 4 to 6:30 and enjoy a pre-sale at the same time because we're going to lay them all out for you. And at the sale, you can fill your bag a bag with books for $20, and books are going to be two for three, $2 a piece or three for $5. And jewelry is going to be a range from $1 to $30, $35. Don't forget to bring your dough, as Michael Beckwith says, for your donations. I love that. Okay, and if you we're going to continue the sale on the 16th at Pat's house. So the same thing, whatever's left will continue at that at Pat's house. Please read all the updated information and continue to keep up with us in our weekly connection that should be coming to you every Wednesday. If it's not, let me know so we can correct that. Also, we encourage you to subscribe and to like and to share, like Amy was saying. And thanks a lot for listening to all of our announcements. I appreciate it. We appreciate it. And now I'll move on to the inspirational reading. So the inspirational reading is what Amy said for our theme that ends this week. It's traversing timeless truth. And I'm going to read today a reading that's written by one of our members, Pat McCauley. And I know you will appreciate the depth of her initiating this discussion about timeless truth. In our outer world, it can be a challenge to recognize the truth that is timeless. Yet in the spiritual dimension, we always discover the timeless truth. A timeless truth that we know is that all energy, and there is an energy within, that all is energy, and that there is an energy within us and all around us. It not only has been given many names, yet it cannot be named with our limited consciousness. But one thing we do call it is love. We can either flow with it or fight against it. Another timeless truth is that love holds everything connected as one: people, our physical world, events, everything. In our fast technological age, we see the connectedness. News travels very fast. It's one thing to discover timeless truths and another to act as we embody them. So I invite us to think, in addition to traversing truths, to embody them. One could ask oneself, what are the truths I currently embody? How do we go about discovering that? What we do with our time and our money gives us clues as to the truth that we hold dear. In the outer world, we can look at the credit card purchases, checkbook ledgers, and our calendars to see what we value and acknowledge as truths that are worth living for. Inwardly, we can look at how we act toward ourselves, other people, and the world situation. What would you say your love quotient is? If we look at our daytime hours, what percentage of the time are we loving in what we do and say and think and who we are? What is our love quotient? How much of our time is spent in the present response versus past reaction of regret, shame, blame, and unforgiveness of the future or the future with anxiety and fear? In one of our center book groups, we are reading The Way of the Master, The Way of the Heart, and we have been invited to take 5 minutes each day to sit, be quiet, and embody the Christ consciousness of love, to feel it, to know it, to recognize it, to be it. I would invite us all to join in this 5 minutes each day. What is one way to traverse timeless truth in truthless times? Making choices to embody love with our thoughts, our feelings, and our actions. And so it is. Thank you, everyone. And thank you, Pat.
Yes, thank you, Jan and Pat. Thank you, Jan, for all the announcements. Thank you for reading Pat's very potent, profound, powerful writing this morning for us. I love that. 5 minutes each day. So that's what you're doing in the book group?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Yes. I would like to also say yes, let's do that. And as we move into Christmas, of course, because we're, what did you say? Each day to embody the Christ consciousness. Yeah, I like that. Let's do it. I say yes.
I agree. We
Okay,
agree. Our
fantastic.
book group agrees. Yay.
I love that. Yeah, that's wonderful. And I love that about the love quotient. What are you, your love quotient for the day? Yeah, it's a great thing to check out. Are you in the past, in the future, or are you right here now? Thank you so much. I'm going to hand the screen over to Brittany. She has our next song for us this morning. Thank you, beloved.
Thank you. That was really cool and profound. That asking yourself, what is your love quotient? And then also the timeless truths in a truthless time. That was a really profound play on words there too. This song may be familiar, maybe not, but I couldn't help but think about the times that we are living in. And especially this time of year, so many things are going on in the world, and there are so many things at play that try to divide us as people. And when we are meant to be unified, we are meant to be living in unity and love with one another. So this song is Don't Dream It's Over. So we know that it never is over because life is eternal and cyclical, and there is always hope. So, you may know this one. This is an old favorite of mine. There is freedom within, there is freedom without. Try to catch the deluge in a paper cup. There's a battle ahead. Many battles are lost, but you never leave the end of the road while you're traveling with me. Hey now, don't dream it's over. Hey now, when the world comes in, they come to build a wall between. Now I'm towing my car. There's a hole in the roof. My possessions are causing me suspicion, but there's no proof. And the papers today tell of war and of waste, but you turn right over to the TV page. Steps to the door of your heart, and there's shadows ahead, barely clearing that roof. Get to know the feeling of liberation and relief. Hey now, hey now, don't dream. Thank you
Did
so
anybody?
much.
Thank you so much. Did anybody else hear that song in a whole different way this time?
It's
Wow.
such a familiar tune, but the words are really pretty real.
They really are. And I feel like I know that song well, but I just heard it for the first time. Thank you.
Amazing. Thank you.
Yeah.
That's
Don't you
awesome.
love when,
Awesome.
yeah. Don't you love when that happens? Wow. Goodness. Okay, thank you so much. I'm handing the screen over to Jan. She has our prayer of plentitude for us this morning. Thank you, beloved.
Okay, what a perfect intro for our prosperity blessing. And this is our time. This is our time to just shout it out and to affirm our prosperity and our abundance and to affirm gratitude for everything in our lives. And so I invite you right now to join me as we move into this space of oneness. Let's do it. Let's take a deep breath and release that breath. And another deep, deep breath. And release. And close your eyes and join me. We quiet our minds. We open to the great realization of abundance of this universe and in our lives. We connect with an inner stillness that is grounded in the divine flow of giving and receiving. We practice gratitude for all that life gives us and accept that there is more coming our way. We know it is all about circulation. We align and operate from our divine nature to give freely from a compassionate heart to ourselves and to others. We are assured that we are never void. There is always enough. We set our intention to engage in right action that attracts all opportunities to prosper. We are each very grateful, expanding in this human life, spirits in this human life expanding. We are gratefully succeeding in stepping forward into our greater good and greater good for all in the world and for the world itself. And so it is. Thank you so much.
Muted. I'm muted. I said, thank you so much. I appreciate you, Dan. I'm handing the screen back over to Brittany for our final song this morning. Thank you, beloved.
Thank you so much. That was very powerful just to take a deep breath and let it go. This song is called Let Go. And this is a song I've listened to many, many times and I've meditated to and I've cried to. And I just invite you to let go in this moment and surrender to the flow of this beautiful, beautiful world and universe. Thank you so much for being here with me. Drake up, baby, down. Are you in or are you out? Leave your things behind, 'cause it's all going on without you. Excuse me, too busy writing your tragedies, mishaps. Bubble wrap, and you know I do what you like. So let go.
such boundless pleasure. We've no time for later now. You can't escape your own arrival. 20 seconds to comply. So let go, let go. Just get in. Oh, well, what you waiting for? It's all right, 'cause there's beauty in a breakdown. Let go, let go. Just get in. Oh, it's so amazing here. It's all right, 'cause there's beauty in a breakdown. Hey, hey, oh, hey, hey.
Beautiful. Thank you so much,
Thank you
Brittany.
so much.
I've said this before, I'll say it again. So when she's on the stage, we all get tickets for the front row. Which I see. I hold that vision. I see it.
Me too.
Thank you, precious. Thank you, Jan and Brittany, for bringing your spirit, your souls, your essence, your sweetness to us this morning and activating this space. We are so grateful for both of you. Blessings, blessings. I will see you on this end of our technology stream. Mwah. I love you both. Yeah. I'm here with Michael J, Mystic Mike, Prince of Peace. For those of you getting to know this amazing beloved soul, Michael is an inspirational speaker, life coach, and development consultant, and Agape licensed practitioner. He has worked in social service environments, middle and high schools with incarcerated men, women, and juvenile teens. He is also the founder of One Foot Journey Coaching. The focus of the work is to become a master of the keys of emotional intelligence that support universal principle and law. These keys allow you to discover who you truly are from the inside out and discover what is yours to do here, which means this work applies to all human beings. And the work is not new work, and it is yours to do if you choose. Michael's vision for his life is to be a loving presence for the evolution of humanity, and so it is. This is the case. Let me just move us into this moment with a prayer and hand the screen over to Michael J. We are here now, filling up our lungs with this precious breath of the spirit overflowing with gratitude. We know we are divine and we abide in oneness in the spirit of God, perfect, holy, and whole. We are God expressing. We claim dominion over our lives. We allow the power and presence to guide us, thankful for this call to show up living in love, walking our talk. We are not here playing small. We are here to represent the beauty, the light, the power, and extraordinary presence of peace and love. We bless Michael J. today, and we open our hearts and souls to his message that is flowing through him, ready for us to receive. I release this word in love, for love, and as love. So it is, Ashe. Amen. Amen. Thank you, dear one. Handing the screen over.
Wow. Thank you. What a beautiful prayer. I'm excited because everybody watching me is God. Everybody, all of you, You are God in your own unique expression. You are God, and you are God looking at God. So let's stop with the small labels, you know what I mean? Black people, white people, big people, small people. Let's go with the real deal. I see God. Every human being is an expression of God. That's just amazing. That blows me away. When I really sit and allow myself to live in the truth of what I'm thinking and knowing, we are all God. We are all made in the image and likeness of God. We go looking for love and we are love. Stop that. Stop going to look for love. Be love. Stop wondering if God is around. Be God. God is inside of you, inside of me, being itself in most magnificent ways. When you look at the magnificence of this body, the intelligence of this body that we're in, it does a lot of stuff we never have to think about. We take that for granted. Let's stop talking about abundance, because we are all living in abundance in every moment of our life, because every breath you take is full of abundance. Every breath is abundance. Every breath is abundance. We already have abundance. And if we already have abundance and it flows in and out of us effortlessly and easily, we are already in the flow. Unless we neglect who we truly are. We have to wake up to the fact that we are God. I know you see Michael, but God sees itself as Michael. I know you see Amy. God sees itself as Amy. God sees itself. It's time, people, for us to see ourselves in each other. It's time for us to recognize that we are not looking, seeking, or allowing anything other than the truth of our being to be expressed in the most authentic way it can be expressed. And the most authentic thing you could ever express is that I am life. I am God. I am a unique expression of the creation of the universe, the universe, the universe. I'm not talking about the block. I'm not talking about Compton, where I came from. I'm talking about the universe, okay? I'm not just talking about the South Side or Chicago or you know, Europe. I'm talking about the universe. When you look into the sky, what you see is God. When you walk on the ground, what you feel is gravity. It's God. Everything that is creating our life to be in the flow that it's in physically is God in action. Everything. So it's time that we got in flow with God in action. It's time. Let go of time. God does not exist in time. God exists in the generous present moment. I no longer have to look for God. I can remember growing up and wanting to see God as a kid. You know, I remember those days in church. I see these people doing and going through all these experiences, and I'm like, I want to see God. I want to see God. What do they say I don't see? How come I don't see God? The reason I didn't see God when I was growing up, because God never told me that. Nobody in church told me God was inside of me. And when you look in the mirror, you're looking at God. Every time you look in the mirror, you're looking at God. You're not looking at some human being that's trying to be, you know, expressed in the world or acknowledged in the world. You're looking at God. Let's start with the truth. Let's live in the truth. While you're looking at the screen, you're looking at me and you're looking at Amy, and maybe you see other things in your life, I want you to breathe into your heart. The breath is the most powerful, abundant experience in life. You can't be in abundance in life if you're not breathing. You can't. You just go back to that place you were before you were born. You go back to the creation itself. But here on this planet, in this body, every breath is abundance. Every human being on the planet is in that breath. Every human being, every living thing is in that breath. If it is living, it is because of the breath. So let's take our doingness as human beings off of destroying God. Let's stop doing that. Let's stop judging ourselves. Let's stop judging other people. Let's stop looking at people and seeing a defined expression of them. Let's look at people with our insight and see that this is another expression of God. Not a label because of the outer appearance, but you can see God. We do it so simply and so easily when we see children. We see that essence and that uniqueness in the child. And we lose our empathy for the human being that's been going through the challenges called life. We don't have the same empathy for human beings as we have for children. We have tons of empathy for children, tons of compassion for children. But when you get older, we seem to lose that intelligence. We are God in expression, in unique divine expression. You and I are responsible for this experience called life that we are in. We are in the co-creative process called being in life. So let's stop being in effect of life and let's start being in life as God, as a God being. There's this intelligence in you and in me that takes care of so much of this body, the eyesight, the hearing, the movement, the mobility, the digestion, the flow of the blood, the beating of the heart. I mean, there's so many abundant things happening just so this body can be on this screen to be with you. I'm grateful. I'm grateful for that creation. I'm living in it. All is well. I'm responsible for how I respond to life, because I can react to life and lose its magic and its miracles, or I can respond to life and gain its mystical pleasure. I'm responsible for this life experience. God created me to be itself. God didn't create me to be an egotistical fool running the streets and doing whatever I want. God created me so it could be itself and see itself as me. I want to be God. I want to be in the breath. I want to be in the prayer. I don't want it to be outside of me. I want it to come from me. If I am energy, if you are energy, I have a responsibility to that energy. And the responsibility is to allow myself to guide that energy that I am into the most highest frequencies that it can be. So if I'm being God, I'm never using my energy to push down, hold down, hold down, judge, criticize, anything in life. I'm in the awe of having the intelligence to mold energy with my consciousness by seeing it as divine, as beautiful, as intelligent, as amazing. You and I are energy. What kind of energy are you putting out? Are you putting out God energy or limited human energy? Afraid, scarce energy? Or are you putting out love and compassion and peace and grace and gratitude and empathy and authenticity? What are you putting out to say that you are God? God would never say and do some of the things that we say and do. So let him go and be God and be the frequency of things that you design. I'm calling you out. I'm calling you out. It's time to stop talking about the past, because God is not in the past. And there's no such thing as the presence of God in the past. God is always and only in the present moment. So let's stop talking about the past. Now, you're talking to a guy who studied psychotherapy and who always goes back to the, who is helping people go back to the root cause of their behavior and their problems. Okay, no, I've left that. Forget that. Let's go back to the present moment and remember who we truly are, so that the problem disappears, because it cannot match the truth of our being. No problem you and I go through can match the truth of our being. And the truth of our being is that when we put our consciousness, our attention, our awareness, our energy, our mindfulness, our thoughts, feelings, and emotions in the present moment, we put our full trust and faith in what is in the present moment, which is where God is, you're in the presence of God, you become magnified by that truth. You are God. I am God. Let's stop playing the victim, because the victim never comes out great in the movie. But the goodness does. God does. Let's be God. Be your awareness. Let's be awareness. Let's not put awareness outside of us. Let's be awareness and send our awareness into the world, into life, to be aware of where we are not being God, where we are not loving, not being kind, not being open, not being present, 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 not being present. When we're caught in the future and caught in the past, we're not being present. When we're not present, we're not with God. When we're not with God, we don't have our greatest power expressing itself through us. The light starts to dim itself because we're not being who we truly are. We are God, a unique expression of creation with so many gifts, an incredible intelligent body that can take care of itself. But the more divine intentions I give it, the greater it becomes. Is that amazing or what? You can't get that at Walmart. You can't get that at the mall. You can't get it in your car. The power I'm talking about is the power of your breath, the power of your intelligence in your heart, the power that governs your life experience right now, the power that gives you the intelligence to be aware. So let's be God and let's be mindful. Let's be mindful of the magical, powerful things this body can and cannot do. Let's be mindful of that. Let's be mindful of the energy that comes out of our expression. Let's be mindful of that. If you want to be intelligent, be mindful of what you're expressing in the world, because God don't express junk. God don't express put downs. God don't express judgment. God express love, appreciation, acceptance, inclusion. Be mindful. If you really want your intelligence to expand and to grow, stop thinking. What I've learned about thinking is that what thinking does is it takes your attention away from the God being you are, because you start believing your thinking. You start believing in it, you know? And the reason we believe in our thinking is because this incredible intelligent thing that God created is thought, right? Energy. And thought energy is when you think a thought in it and you put energy behind it, thought goes, pew! Thought takes off and it starts to go into form of some kind. And as long as you keep putting that intention and that energy into that thought, that's what materializes in life. We are creators. It's simple. Simple manifestation. Simple manifestation. Put the energy behind the thoughts that you hold on to, and it becomes that which you think about. It's simple. It's simple. It's science. It's not complicated. But the thing is, the thought has no discernment. You have the discernment. The thought doesn't have the regulation. You have the regulation. The thought doesn't have the intention. You have the intention. It is your energy that you put into the thought that materializes what we put in our world. It is your energy that you put in the thought that either calms the relationships we're in or it pokes at them in an unintelligent way. You're responsible for thought. Just like you're responsible for energy, just like you're responsible for awareness, and just like you're responsible for mindfulness, you are responsible for catching thought, letting thought go, the energy you put behind thought, and the thoughts you let run you. You're responsible. So take responsibility for thought. It's energy. It's consciousness. It's invisible, it's automatic, it happens automatically. You know, it comes from your senses and it comes from your moods and it comes from the things in life that poke at you, the things you say you don't like. Stop not liking something. Just let it, don't attach to it. You don't have to like or dislike something, just love it or leave it alone. I know what that means now. You don't like everything, you're not going to, But we have the responsibility to love everything. That's a responsibility. But something more powerful than thoughts is feelings. I mean, God put in this body these senses, you know, this thing of smell and touch with your hands, and this thing called seeing and hearing and tasting. I mean, God created all of that for this body. And then when we pay attention to those things, we have a more experience, a more aware experience of life when we're aware of our senses, okay? Now, feelings are energy and vibration. Feelings come into our body and they start to react in our body. And it's intelligent for us to think that, oh, I have a feeling. What is the feeling telling me? Because it's not a thought. It's a feeling. So if you take your feelings and start putting thoughts on top of them, your thoughts become your feelings, but you haven't investigated the feeling. So now you're chasing a thought on a feeling that's incongruent. Maybe the feeling you're having is joy, but no one never taught you what joy was. Maybe the feeling you're having is empathy, but no one taught you what empathy is. Maybe the feeling you're having is anger. And everyone can tell you what anger is. But most people are absolutely wrong about anger, because anger is nothing more than feedback, like anything else in life. You don't have to be angry, but it can certainly wake you up to being more present. Oh, I got this thing called anger in my body. Why? What's it teaching me? Or you can act on it. Most people act on their thoughts and feelings. Respond to your thoughts and feelings. That's being intelligent. When we respond to the feelings and the senses inside of us, when we direct the feelings that we want to have and the experiences that we want to create, we're being emotionally intelligent. When we let those feelings and thoughts run us, we're being victims. So it doesn't matter what your traumas are in the past, in the present moment, in this generous present moment, is where you create the magnificent future. The magnificent change, transformation. It's where you become God in the present moment. So one minute, look at the screen, breathe into your heart space deeply and slowly, and know that every breath is God coming into your being. Every breath is God coming into your being, and God is love. And peace, harmony, order, balance. God is the present experience. God is the present moment. God is joy. God is now. You can absolutely create the feelings you want by recognizing first that you are God and you are those feelings. And those feelings are giving you divine information. They're telling you things about your body, or they're telling you things about your environment, or they're telling you things about your heart, or they're telling you things about your mind. Feelings are powerful. Stop throwing them at yourself and others and use them to be God. God gave us this intelligent feedback and we use it on each other. We use it in how we criticize our siblings, we use it in how we criticize our neighbors. We use it in how we criticize people who are physically looking different than us. Or we use it in how we criticize the male energy and the female energy. Let's stop being unintelligent. Let's be God. I wonder what would heal in the world if you decided, your world, your life, your world, if you decided, I'm just going to be God. I'm not going to be Michael Allen anymore, because Michael Allen has baggage. Michael Allen is limited because he just lives in the human realm. He doesn't recognize who he is and who he can become. You are God and you can become anything. And it can all happen in your beautiful imagination. So if we're going to be God, we have to be absolutely responsible for the emotions that we express. And a lot of people mix their feelings and their emotions. My definition of emotions is simply this. The emotions inside of you, you're responsible for. So if you're responsible for your energy and you're responsible for your awareness and you're responsible for your mindfulness and you're responsible for your thoughts and your feelings, then you must be responsible for how you express your intelligence about your experience. So if you're expressing your thoughts and feelings to someone, but you're doing it in a way that they feel harmed by your words, harmed by your expression, harmed by your tone, that's not intelligent. And that's not being authentic either. So if you decide that before you express your thoughts and feelings through your emotions, if you decide that I will only express what will be a good experience for me and the person I'm communicating with, otherwise I will not express any words, because words have power with an unintelligent energy behind them. It's a power. People do it all the time. They deny that they're doing it. Isn't that crazy? Isn't it crazy how we talk about the world and each other, and then we deny that we're judging people? It's crazy. It cracks me up. It's like, wow, you just totally disrespected that person. But you get to say it because you don't think it's a big deal. You don't catch it that way. Awareness. We're responsible for our awareness. And here's the last one. And it's not the last one. It is the final key in terms of being emotionally intelligent and being in God frequency and God energy and God vibration. And it's beliefs. You know, beliefs are created in so many different ways. They're created by our experience. They're created by our environment. They're created by what we've learned and what people have told us. And we take those beliefs growing up very early in life, and we make those beliefs our own because they were just given to us. No one taught us that a belief is a decision. And once you make that decision and you stick to it, you are now living that belief. So if you decide that that belief does not work for you or does not align with you, then you change your reality. You change your energy. You change your frequency, because you're deciding if the belief that I'm living works for me. And if it doesn't, just decide to have a different belief. I think we put too much, I have put so much energy into my old beliefs. And now, all I do is decide, do I want that belief or not? No, I don't want that belief. Okay. Then it no longer has real estate in my consciousness. It no longer has real estate in my heart. I let go. Let's be God all the time, every moment. Let's be God. Let's be love. Let's be joy. Let's be fun. Let's be creative. Let's not settle for being in the body. Let's not settle for being the body. Let's not settle for being human. Let's go, whoa, I came through this human experience, but I'd rather be God within this human experience, not just a human in the human experience. You follow me? Be God in your humanness. Be God in your way, your choices, your changes, your transformations, your words. Be God in your breath. Know that every breath is the breath of God. Every breath is the breath of God, which means you are alive in this body because of the breath of God. So get excited about the breath. Get excited about how you can use it to magnify your frequency, your energy, your awareness, your thoughts, your feelings, and your emotions. You can manage so much of your life if you take full responsibility for having fun with your breath. I'm having fun with my breath. I love hot focus breathing. It changes my state. I love Wim Hof breathing. I love that intense breathing. I love holotropic breathing. When you can breathe and change your state and know that God is the breath, you are in God and God is in you. That's oneness. That's the union of the physical and the mystical, the magical, your breath. Follow your breath. I love you all because I know I'm talking to God. And I love that everything God has created, I love it all. I don't love everything man has created, but I love a billion, trillion things that God has created. And if it's intelligent and it supports life and humanity, it came from a God thought, not a limiting thought or not a judgmental thought. It came from a divine thought. So every time you become aware of your breath, just be God in that breath. You don't have to pick anything else. You don't have to solve any problems. Just be God in that moment. The present moment is what we create. So what if you spent most of your day noticing the present moment without judgment, just noticing it and letting it be? And then you get to choose how you want to feel about it. If you want to feel powerful about noticing the present moment, feel powerful. If you want to feel good about pausing and being in the present moment, feel good. If you want to have fun in that present moment and smile, smile. Because in that present moment, you've come into alignment with who you truly are, and the truth gets magnified. I believe. I don't know about you guys. That's what I believe. Know that you are God. 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 Be God. Be God. Be God. Be God. And call it whatever you like. I love calling it God. I love you all. Have a grand day. Come to the workshop because I'm going to go deeper. I'm going to go deeper in the workshop. Just want you to know.
We're diving,
We're diving.
diving in.
This community inspired living. We are diving in.
We like to dive
We
around
like.
here. It's true.
We
It's
avoid
definitely
those times.
true.
No diving. Now we're
We
going to hit.
don't play small around here. Michael J, bringing it, just bringing it in, sliding into home. Wow. I love it. I love it. You said.
Always talking to myself, you know. What could I
I
say?
know. I know. I'm glad I'm right there with you,
Anything
in
I
you.
personally, like, you know, talking to myself. Everything I said, I was talking to Michael. I was, you know, if you caught it, if it touched you, if it moved you, if it inspired you, yeah, you can have it too. Take it with you. Or
Amen.
you could just ignore it. Don't let it move you. Be you.
Time to get in the flow. God is in the generous present moment. You
Right.
said that. You said that today.
Yes.
Quotable moment.
Right. Right.
Yeah. Great stuff here. Carol, thank you for taking notes. Carol takes notes for me. Before you share your thoughts and feelings, be aware of your words and how you express with others. Yeah, I like that one too. What did I write down about the thoughts? The thought doesn't have discernment. Did anybody hear that today? I heard that one. The thought doesn't have discernment. We are responsible for the energy and the consciousness of the thought. Boom. Right there.
For the thought, we're responsible for the awareness of the effect of the thought. Responsible,
Amen.
you know, spirituality is, it's work.
To practice, yeah.
It's work. Let's be honest. Spirituality is work. If you want to be a spiritual being, you got to do the work.
Yeah,
You
you
got
do.
to work. And you got to keep diving into it because it's not an outside, you know, the intelligence of spirituality is not in the outer world, it's in the inner world.
Right. Yeah, that's the not playing small part, you know.
You got to go inside places you've never been, open to things you've never thought imaginable. Spirituality is no,
Who's there?
but it's cool. I love it. It's fun. It's, you know, it's a good time. I love being in spiritual harmony. I love it. It's a blast.
Let me see what we have going on here in the feed. Our beliefs are what create our reality and frequency. We put so much energy into our beliefs, they take real estate in our heads and hearts. Yeah, that was good. Get excited about your breath. Yes, focus breathing. Jan says, I think that was what Pat was saying too. The love, be love, and we know that God is love. Yes. What is the name of the breath work? Oh, I think Wim Hof is what you said, right?
Wim
Notice present moment, let it be. Carol says, I love you. Love, love, love. I'm totally going to be at the workshop. Yes, which, speaking of, thank you everybody for being part of this conversation, the energy, the consciousness of what we're speaking of here, which is so. I just read a note that I wrote that I just want to go back to because it was a good one. It was so great. Everything so that you said was wonderful. So you can't be in abundance. That you can't be in abundance of life if you're not breathing. And we all have the breath, so we are all in abundance. Hello. Hello. I love that.
Abundance. Let's be in abundance. Oh,
Abundance.
another breath. Whoa, another breath. Oh, another breath. Oh
Yeah. Great. Good stuff. Chew on that one. Okay, everybody. We have 20 minutes before we go into the workshop for a deeper dive. Can you imagine that? Are you ready? I know you are. I know this community is always ready. It's a sacred yes here. So, we are going to wrap up here and go take a quick nourishment break, hydration break, and then come back to the Zoom link, which I'm going to drop here in the Facebook live stream chat. It's also on our website, unityinspiredliving.org. Right there on the homepage, you'll see a picture of Brittany, Michael J., and then the link right into the Zoom room. Invite anybody. We come one, come all. We welcome everybody into the Zoom room because we know that it is a divine appointment. And if you are there, you are meant to be there. So we are going to close now with our prayer of divine awakening. So let me share the screen with you and we'll close with this and take a quick break and move on into the deep dive, deeper dive. I invite you to speak this as a declaration for your day, for your life. The prayer of divine awakening. It's a new day, a beautiful day, a new beginning. I embrace this day with new eyes, an open heart, and expansive mind. I choose my vibrational frequency deliberately and consciously, harmonizing with life's events. I am receptive to source energy, divine guidance and wisdom available to me at all times in the present moment. I commit to serve unconditional love fully and completely. I move forward in a state of appreciation, an extension of the one magnificent power and presence. I am sovereign, whole, and free, claiming dominion over my life as I go in peace and awaken to my divinity. And so it is. Shine on, bright beings of love and light. We will see you in the Zoom room in just a very short few minutes. Blessings and love. Thank you, Michael J., Mystic Mike. We are so grateful for you. You bless us. You are a gift. We love
Pleasure.
you.
Good day.
Bye, everybody.